In today's video, I will repair this Sharp Mini Split Air Conditioner dead circuit board. I think it has gone through a repair by another repairman. The fuse has been removed from here. I can clearly see a wire has been joined instead. Two capacitors were installed here. I have temporarily desoldered them from the circuit. This kind of dead circuit board has two methods of checking. The first is to check the circuit board's physical condition, because if anything in the circuit board is physically blown up, burned, or burst, the circuit board will not work at all. Must check the fuses of such circuit boards. This circuit board has multiple fuses installed. If a single fuse between these multiple fuses blows up, the circuit will cause issues. This is the main fuse for passing the electricity to the rest of the circuit. This is the second fuse that you are seeing. The DC power supply goes to the IPM through this fuse, and then the compressor will start to work. If this fuse had blown, the compressor would not have started, and maybe the rest of the circuit board would have powered on. Further, smaller fuses are installed on this circuit board. This fuse number is FU3, which is for the SMPS. 320 DC volts are passed directly through this fuse to the chopper. The switching IC in the SMPS turns the chopper on, and then this circuit board works. The fourth fuse trace, which I showed you earlier, where a wire is installed with its fuse trace. The number of this fuse is FU2. I feel like this circuit was short-circuited, which made this fuse blow up. If the surge voltages had passed through this circuit, these MOV, which are installed for the protection in the circuit, would have blown up. But nothing happened to these MOVs. We can check the circuit further with a multimeter. But before that, I will pass electricity through the circuit board to see whether it shows any fault or not. I have installed two multimeters with the circuit board. The probes of the one multimeter are attached to the rectifier to check whether the electricity is passing here or not. The probes of the second multimeter I have attached to the main electricity supply of the circuit board, red probe with the fuse and the black probe with the relay. Let's check whether the electricity passes through the circuit or not. 229 volts are shown on this multimeter, whereas no voltages are passing through the rectifier of this circuit board. Some kind of smell is coming from the circuit board. Something is heating up in the circuit board, so I will cut off the electricity from the circuit board. Let's check what thing is heating up in the circuit board. The PTC sensor in this circuit board has heated up. I am also checking some other IC, which is heating up. No other component is heating up. The PTC sensor is installed near the relay. I have now set this multimeter on ohms mode. I have attached the multimeter probes to the PTC sensor to check why it is heating up. The value of the PTC sensor is almost 180 ohms. Before this, the value was 42 ohms. I didn't pass electricity through the circuit board. The electric plug is unplugged. I will now pass electricity through it. We will see the electricity on this multimeter. 230 are shown on the multimeter. The value of the PTC sensor has started to fluctuate, and I can smell the burning odor. If the PTC sensor in the circuit board is heating up, it is not necessary that it is defective, because its function is such that if any component inside the circuit board is damaged, it will heat up due to the high load on it and will eventually disconnect the electricity for safety. The electricity from the PTC sensor moves to the bridge rectifiers, and then the capacitors. Let's check them both. I have put the multimeter on diode mode to check the rectifiers. The voltage drop on the diode of the rectifier is a little less, but let's see the next one. This second bridge rectifier is bad. It is showing zero voltage drop. I will change the polarity of the probes. It is still showing zero voltage drop. This means it is bad. I have tested the IPM, and it is okay. Let's check the capacitor one time. I have removed two capacitors. The capacitor is fine. I will now remove the rectifier from the circuit board and replace it with a new one. The rectifier has easily come out after desoldering it. The rectifier is 25 amperes. I have this new rectifier, which I will install inside the circuit board. Before soldering the bridge rectifier, I installed the heat sink on top of it to prevent an air gap between both. The rectifier could heat up if a gap is left between both the heat sink and the rectifier. The circuit board is working now, so I have attached it with the outdoor unit for testing. The LED light of the circuit board is blinking normally. The circuit board is still heating up, but we will have to see it. The outdoor fan has started to rotate. The compressor will also start in a few seconds. So what's going on here? Let me explain when the compressor starts. The compressor has started to work. It speeded up a little and stopped. Now, I will disconnect the electricity from the circuit board and tell you what happened. The PTC sensor has again started to heat up. What is the reason for the PTC sensor to heat up again? Is it faulty? No, it is not defective. This is its function. The load of the compressor is transferred to this PTC sensor. The reason behind this is that the relay installed with the PTC sensor is not switching properly. That is why all the load is transferred to this PTC sensor. And this, after heating up, is tripping the compressor. I will check the relay now. So, if I check the relay without passing electricity to the circuit board, it should not show continuity between the two terminals. The value of the continuity is 53 ohms. The reading is of the PTC sensor. Because both the pins of the PTC sensor are joined with relay pins, it can be checked with two more methods. The one is that I will check the 12 volts on the coils of the relay. If proper 12 volts are passing here, then it means the relay is bad. Or if the 12 volts are not passing, then the relay is okay and some other component in the circuit is bad. I will pass electricity through the circuit board and will check voltages 12 volts through the relay. But before that, I will confirm whether 12 volts are present in this circuit or not. 12 volts that I will check are written on this section of this circuit board. This is its main supply where the chopper passes the DC 12 volts. So the multimeter is showing 11.8 DC volts which are coming from the chopper. This means the 12 volts are present in this circuit board. Let's check the voltages on this relay. 12 volts are not passing through this relay. This means the fault is on another component around it. The relay is not turning on, which means the microcontroller is not able to turn it on. This is a ULN2003 IC. If this is faulty, the relay will not work. I will replace it with a new one. I have changed the IC in this circuit board. Now I will power on the circuit board. When the switching relay turns on, it makes a beeping sound, indicating it has turned on. I will pass electricity through the circuit board to check does it turns on. Now the proper sound of the relay being turned on is heard. It had no such sound before. I have powered the air conditioner again by installing the circuit board. So this happens. First of all, the PTC sensor passes the electricity, and the circuit switches on, which starts up the microcontroller. After this, the switching relay turns on, and all the load is transferred to the relay. This makes the compressor work softly, without tripping. The fan motor of the air conditioner has started to work. The compressor will also start. Now, let's check whether the PTC sensor heats or not. The compressor has started, and the PTC sensor is now not heating up. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch the next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.